Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to show you how we can create one amazing chat app using MIT App Inventor. Since here, that one app in the emulator, and that the same app that I have installed on my Android phone also. Okay, as you can see here the name. So let's put the name here. Okay, and let's type something message. Hi, Ellie, how are you? Okay, and let's click on the send button. Saurabh and hi Ellie, how are you? Put my name here. Suppose my name is Ellie here, and then type here, okay, how are you? And let's click on the send button. Now you will see here in the both app you'll find the message here. Like this, you can do the multiple chat. So let's click on the new project, and my project name is chat new app. This chat have the features. This chat will not destroy even you if you close your app. Suppose once you uninstall your app, still this chat will be in the database, because we are going to use your CloudDB. Okay, and there's one more option, like if you want to clear all the chat that is stored in the CloudDB. So we have one button, that clear chat, so you can use this button. So let's start this app. Okay, so that's our first screen. And I'm going to use here the layouts. In the left side, you'll find the layout, and just drag and drop the vertical arrangement and make this width and height is fill parent. I'm going to use here two horizontal arrangement, like one is here like this, and make this width is fill parent like this, and same, just copy paste another arrangement horizontal. Done. Now we need click on user interface. We need a list view in the first, and what I will do here in the horizontal arrangement one, I'm going to use here two text box. So text box is this, text box one, text box two, and for another I need two buttons here, one button for clear chat, another button for sending the message. Okay, now click on the horizontal arrangement and make both thing in a center. Okay, like alignment and horizontal, like center. Click on text box one and make this width is 30%, and make this width is like 60%. Okay, now click on this button one and make this font size at least 16, and change the text to clear chat, and another button you can make the text to something send message this. Okay, and let's design these buttons. So I'm gonna use here the, you will see the shape, so I'm gonna use the, you know, rounded. This one is also rounded, and I need to put the color. So let's do one thing first, click on horizontal arrangement and make this both in a center like this. Okay, cool. But I'm gonna use here one label here to make some space between both the, you know, buttons. So for that I need to just remove the text from the button like this. I need to make some space between the, you know, the labels. So what I will do, I'll just use here any label or wish like this here, and I'm gonna just remove the text from here. Now I need to add, you know, some designs colorful. So how can I do this? So simply I'm going to use here the color, okay, .co. So you can generate, so start generator. So this will generate some color plates for you. This dark color for the background, okay, for the screen background, background color, custom, so like this, okay. And what I will do here for the this list view also, background color, I'm going to make this none, okay, like this. For the vertical arrangement, I'm gonna use here the custom color is the same that we have used in the screen. For the, you know, button, I'm gonna use this both light colors, and I thought like let's have some, you know, some light color also. So yeah, it's look great. Okay, so I'm gonna use for this one for the background. So that's our overall app. Okay, so now what we'll do here, that's the design. Now in the left side you'll find here the option of CloudDB. So go to the connectivity, sorry, the storage,
And you see the CloudDB, just drag and drop this. Done. Now let's go to the blog section. Okay, so when someone click on the send button, okay, it means this one button, send message button, button 2. So we need to just click on the button 2 like this. So we need to just click on CloudDB and you'll find here the append value to the list. We'll call this, okay, and in which tag we have to store the value. So I'll just call it here simply like tag, and this is the data, okay, in this tag, and item to be the add. So in which, so I'm going to create one list, okay, and this is the empty list like this, create empty list like this. So this is the tag data, okay, item to add, which item we need to add, okay. So which item, so you'll find, go to the design. So in this text box 1, I'll put the hint tag should be name, okay, this is the name. And for the another is like typing, it means for the message like this. So I'm going to add the both. So I'm going to use here the text field, and I'm going to use the join, and I'm going to use here one more string like this. And I'm going to use the text field, and I'm going to use here the, the data. So text box 1 is for the name dot text like this. Same, just copy paste. For the last one, I'm going to use the message, and for the middle one, I'm going to use here one is like the symbol is like double dot like this. Okay, this data will add in our list. Okay, once I click on the button 2, I need to clear the text box 2. Okay, this I need to clear. Okay, so I can write the another message. So simply go to the blog and simply say text box 2 dot text. This one is like none, just assign the value like this. Okay, done. Now what we need to do, we need to call whenever the data is changed. Okay, so you see the data change, so whenever we store the value, so this will automatically update in the list. Okay, so how this will done, so we need to store this value like list, that global list like this, and we need to fetch the value. Okay, so get value like this. And we need to set this value in the list view. And where is that list view? That list view here. Item. And this is the value. Same thing we have to do for the once the cloud data updated. Okay, or something. So this is the data change, and you'll find the, so this is for data change. And when the CloudDB got the data, got the value, okay. So we'll call the same for again set global value like this and set the value like this. Done. Now whenever someone close the app and whenever they open again the app, so we need to run the screen initialization whenever the people open the app. So on the screen initialization, we need to call the get list CloudDB, and you'll see the get it. We'll fetch the previous chat, okay, like this. And once we got the data, this method will call automatically, okay. And here what I will do here, I'll just call this here again, so I can have the value like this. But which is this list? This is the list, okay. Now if you want to clear the chat, so how you can do that? So we know that in the button 1, on the whenever someone click on to the button 1, so we need to clear the data of tag. So you will see here the clear tag, this one method. And once we clear the data, and the data, you can set the tag value and which tag you need to reset or clear. So this is the data, good. And once we clear the data, we need to fetch again the data to display there is nothing like that. So how can I do this? So simply call again the list view like this. So that's the overall app, okay, to have the amazing chat app. And if people will close this app, still chat will remain here. So if you have any doubt, you can ask me a comment. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel, like this video, and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.